students, we are learning about when the irrational number is given, the two irrational number in the form of binomial, and how to use the identities which we have learned in the polynomial chapters. We used several identities. Now, can we use this identity in case of irrational numbers? In this regard, we did some example problem, and I told you to do the exercise 1.5, the second main problem, simplify. I hope you tried and got the answer. Briefly, I will do it. Just check it. Okay, those who not data, just observe and can take it later. So exercise 1.5. Second one, simplify the each of the following expression. First one, 3 plus square root 3 into 2 plus square root 2. Which formula we have to use here? It is x plus a into, not x plus a, not that formula, all are different. So you have to do directly multiplication. First one, multiply, this one take and multiply by 2. You take this one and multiply by square root 2. So this is equal to, write the first, this first irrational number and multiply by 2. I will write it here. Then plus square root 2 I will multiply. The same irrational number, 3 plus square root 3. Right? Now, 2 into 3. 2, 3 is a 6. Plus, simple, it all plus, so no problem. Plus will come. 2 into square root 3. 2 into square root 3 is 2 square root 3. This is simplified. Or if you can open the bracket, no problem, since it is plus sign. Without bracket, you can write plus. Here, yeah, plus sign, that plus into plus, plus. Square root 2 into 3. I will write the arithmetic number first. 3 square root 2 into 3 is same as 3 into square root 2. Okay, 3 square root 2. Then plus square root 2 into square root 3. Inside you can write. So it is nothing but 6 plus 2 square root 3 plus 3 square root 2 plus square root 6. Since all are different rational numbers, we cannot add them. So we can keep as it is. Okay. Now, second one. So this is the answer. Second one. This is the answer, and The fifth one, the fourth problem. It is same as second problem. What is the fourth problem? The fourth problem again, it is square root 5 minus square root 2. Same number, square root 5 with a plus sign. Right? Same type it is. So same formula you can use again. It is square root 5 minus square root 2 into square root 5 plus square root 2. So A is a square root 5 and B is square root 2. Now it is A square. A is square root 5. It is square. Plus B square. B square is a square root 2. It's a square. And square root and square cancels 5 minus square root and square. I got wrong children, it should be minus and it is 2. 5 minus 2, 3. This example also we got the rational number 3. Right? So second and fourth one is of same type. Now third one, square root 5 plus square root 2, its whole square is how much? A plus B whole square. So which identity you have to use? A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. This is the identity. So square root 5 plus square root 2 whole square is equal to A is square root 5 and B is square root 2. A square, what is our A? Square root 5, it's whole square plus 2 into I write in bracket, it means into 2 into A. A is square root 5 into B. B is square root 2. AB, 2AB, 2 into A into B plus B square. B square, B square root 2. It's a square. So square root and root and square cancels, leaving behind 5 plus 2 into with multiplication and division we can do the root numbers of different numbers, no problem. So we can multiply inside the root sign, square root sign, 5 into 2 plus root, square root and square cancels 2. Now this number 5 plus 2, 7 plus write root as it is, inside 5 2 is a 10. This is the last answer. So in this way, any irrational number, we can use the identity when they are given the bracket of binomial type. Okay? So we can apply it to any real numbers. And third one, they are given, pi is defined as ratio of circumference and diameter. Even though they are given in this manner, but pi, it looks like it is p by q form, then why it is irrational number? You know pi is an irrational number. Why it is irrational number? How to justify our answer? Why it is? Even though we have written p by q form, right? Actually, the circumference is not straight line, right? So, this little complicated manner, if you go through the Google search and find out, they are given explanation, the explanation is little bit higher level to understand. Just for your level, I will say that since circumference is not a straight line, it is a curved one, right? So even though we can use different method to find its length, actually it is not so. One simple example I will say, see, we have circle. So if you want to measure this outline boundary, it is nothing but circumference. One method is roll this circle on a plain ground, and in one full turn it will come in contact with this circumference, right? So one full round, it will make me, it will cover this much, this circle, and it returns, okay? So that way we can measure it. But if you have one more circle inside, imagine, it also covers the same distance when it takes one turn. Yes or no? Now, this circumference and this circumference, is it same? They are different length, right? But when you make one full turn, both will cover the same distance. So it is not so easy. Even though they have written it is a circumference by pi form, in finding the actual value in the form of decimal, they try to get the value of pi. It won't come after the 3 pointer. After that, the decimal numbers will not repeating, and it is non-terminating. Different digits are coming, and it all different digits without terminating. So they finally agreed that it is a irrational number. So no need to write the explanation. Just you can write pi is, the decimal form of pi is non-terminating and non-recurring. So it is an irrational number. This much you can write. Okay, the decimal expansion of pi is non-terminating, non-recurring. Hence, it is irrational. Third one, the decimal expansion of, only this much you write. The decimal expansion of pi is non-terminating, non-terminating. So this much if you write, that is enough. Okay. Now the next one is geometrically how we can write any irrational number, the square root number, square root of even the decimal number, like square root of 4.3, square root of 5.1. You have learned how to represent square root 2, square root 3, etc. on the number line. If the decimal number comes square root of 7.3, etc., there is one geometrical method. Any such numbers with the square root you can find out by one geometrical method. That one I will do in the new class. Okay. Today, the next one, in any problem, when the square root number comes in the form of a fraction, I will show it. So to simplify that calculation, we will change the denominator into a rational form. Example, see, I have square root 2. I want to multiply this to be, or do some calculations. So I don't know to simplify square root 2. So I want to change into some whole numbers. In that regard, how to change this into whole number, or how to remove this square root sign. So there is one procedure without changing the value of 1 divided by square root 2. How to remove this square root sign without changing the actual value of this fraction. Okay. So in such case, the process is called rationalize the denominator. Square root 2 is an irrational number. We are changing that denominator, which is irrational number, into a rational number. That process we are learning today, and the process is called rationalizing the denominator. You know, rational number. So we are making the denominator into rational number. So it is called rationalizing the denominator. So rationalizing the denominator. How to do this process? Rationalizing the denominator. We will take one example. Okay? I said the square root, simple example. Example. Okay? Example. 1 by square root 2. How to rationalize the denominator? Rationalize the denominator, there will be a problem. The square root I want to take. Okay? Now you learn that if you any number inside the square root, if you have, now it will have 2, and if you do square it, if any square root and square root, if you do together, both will go. And the left out is 2, which is a rational number. So I want to do that process. I want to make it square number. Okay? How to make it square number? Square root I have to make square number. Square root of 2 I want to make. So again, and once again I have to multiply this square root by same square root 2. So I will multiply this given number square root 2 by the same square root 2, because it becomes square number, right? But without changing the value I am doing, so same square root I have to multiply the numerator also. Otherwise I am changing the given problem's entire value, which is wrong, which is not the correct case. So like we have seen in fraction, how to convert into equivalent fraction by multiplying by the same number, right? So I am multiplying by the same square root to both numerator and denominator. So I am not altering its real value, but I format I am changing. Okay, so it is equal to 1 into square root 2 is square. 1 square root 2, 1 usually we won't write it square. Numerator whichever we are, we will not give any importance. It may be rational number, irrational number, no problem. Our intention is to make the denominator a rational number. Okay, now square root 2 into square root 2. How many times square root 2 it is multiplied? Square root 2 into square root 2 is 2 times. In the index form we will write like this way. Square root is multiplied 2 times. It is equal to square root 2 divided by, so square root and root sign and square sign cancels. So left out is 2. So I made the denominator a rational number. Yes, it is irrational number, square root, now it is rational number. The original value is same, even though its form is different. Like if you change your dress, you will be the same. Your appearance looks little different if you change your dress, right? Same manner, the numbers format is looks different, but real value of this one is one and the same, these two. But the denominator is changed into rational number. That is our main purpose. Okay? Will we do some more problems? Children, example. Now, if it is square root 3, how to rationalize the denominator? Now, square root of 3 is there. Which number I have to multiply? This one. See the denominator. That same number we have to multiply. Square root 3 into which number? Same square. So it will become square root 3. Square root 3 into square root 3. Square root 3 is the old square. Right? Numerator it as it is, square root and square will cancel each other and we will have only 3. It cancels, 3 is left, right? Now, if I have this type of problem, this type of problem, there are two numbers. What we have to do to remove this? This is an irrational number. rational number minus irrational number is an irrational number. We cannot do anything. We have to keep as it is. This is an irrational number. So I have to change the denominator into rational number. Okay. Now what we have to do? Should we do square root 3 here to the entire this one? Then it become 5 square root 3. The square root 3 remains. So actually, you don't worry, I will tell what we have to do. You know that the identity a minus b or a plus b, same number, if you multiply once again, a minus b into a plus b, or it may be a plus b into a minus b, whichever manner you multiply, the product is a square minus b square. So I will make use of this identity in this regard. So this identity we have to use so that it will change the root sign. Okay. Now this is a, this is b. A minus b into a plus b. Okay. So what I will do? 5 minus square root 3. See the denominator. Same number. You take this two number together. Consider like a binomial. A minus b. Now same number I will take. 5 square root 3. But which sign I have to take? If minus is given, I have to take plus. If plus is given, I will take minus. So take two digits in the denominator, whatever you have, same two digits you take, but with the sign opposite. If minus is given, I have to take plus. If plus is given here, I have to take minus. So then it become a plus b into a minus b, or a minus b into a plus b. Whichever pattern it is, the last answer is square root 3. Now when I multiply the denominator here, numerator also same number I should multiply. Once again, 5 plus square root 3. So I have to multiply both numerator and denominator by the same pattern. Okay. Now it is equal to 1 into any number is same. 1 into any number is same. So I won't write 1. So this is the same number I will get in the numerator, 5 plus square root 3. And in the denominator, it is a is 5, b is square root 3. Right? A square, a is 5, so it is 5 square minus a square minus b square. B is how much? B is square root 3. Square root 3, it's all square. Right? Now it is equal to 5 plus root 3, write as it is. No, nothing to write here. Write as it is, no change. Now here, 5 square. 5 square is how much? 25. Minus 5 into 5, 25. Here, minus. Root sign, square root and square, both will cancel, you will get to 3. This is equal to, we cannot add it right as it is, 5 plus root 3 divided by 25 minus 23, and 25 minus 3, 20. So this is the answer. Now see the denominator, it is a rational number. 22 is a rational number, is an rational number. Got it? So only our process is denominator, we have to rationalize. Understood? One more example we will take. Square root 3 plus square root 2, denominator. I have this number. Okay? Rationalize this number. This is irrational number. Square root 3 plus square root 2. And numerator, no problem, whatever it is. See the denominator. It is in the irrational form. Now, I should change into rational number. There are two terms. In the denominator, there are two numbers, right?
And what we have to do? A plus B in that form. So I should multiply A minus B to the denominator so that I will get square number. So when you do this both number square, the square root symbol cancels. So take that number, given number, square root 3 plus square root 2. Now multiply it with the same numbers. Don't forget, same thing you are doing, whichever that given. Square root 3, square root 2 is given. But which sign you have to take? Plus is given, now you have to take a minus. And same form you have to take in the numerator. Whichever number you are multiplying, same number you have to take. And you have to multiply. Understood? Now, 1 into any number is same number you will get. So it is square root 3 minus square root 2. And in the denominator, in place of a plus b, a minus b. In place of a, I have square root 3, and in place of b, I have square root 2. Right? So it is a square. A square. Answer is a square. A plus b into a minus b is a square. It is root 3. A is root 3. It's a square. Minus sign, not plus sign. Minus b is square root 2. It's a square again. A square minus b square, which is nothing but square root 3 minus square root 2 is equal to square root 10 square cancels 3 minus square root 10 square cancels 2. 3 minus 2 is a 1. It is square root 3 minus square root 2 is 1. So, 1 is a rational number. We changed the denominator, which is in the irrational form, into rational number. Okay. Now, see the exercise 1.5. The fifth main, last one, rationalize the denominators of the following. First one, denominator square root 7. So you have to multiply both numerator and denominator by square root 7. Right? If one number is given, multiply it by the same irrational number. But if there are two irrational numbers given, or one rational, irrational, two binomial form they are given, then you have to take the same numbers with the plus sign if minus is given. If minus is given in the denominator, plus you have to take. If plus is given, take the minus form of that number. So, second problem, square root 7 minus square root 6 is given. So, you take square root 7 plus square root 6 and multiply it by both numerator and denominator. Third one, in the denominator, square root 5 plus square root 2 is given. So, multiply it by square root 5 minus square root 2. And last one, denominator is given square root 7 minus 2. So, which number you have to multiply? The square root 7 plus 2, you have to multiply both numerator and denominator and you have to get the answer. The last one, how to represent geometrically, this one we will see in the next class. Try to complete the fifth problem. Okay, thank you.